The first thing that you need to do before you even begin to write your personal statement is to start researching the courses you want to apply for. You should quite quickly realize that the degrees that you're applying for across those different universities have something in common. Beyond just the title of that degree, they might have a particular way of studying. You need to start using your skills as an online detective. You need to start looking at the online prospectuses, but going further than that. Most websites, most online prospectuses will have links to further information. That's an invitation to you to look at the course structure. Look at what the modules are offering. Look at what you get to choose. Look at some of the subjects that you'll be discussing. That's where you start your research.
The course at Oxford is fairly neuroscience based, so if you end up talking about health psychology or forensic psychology, then it's not going to be relevant to the course, and we're going to feel that it's not the right course for you.
As you start to prepare your personal statement, I think the most important thing is to take your time. Don't leave it till the night before you've been told by your school or college you have to hand a draft in. You need to start weeks, if not months, in advance, thinking about what it is that's genuinely led you towards applying for that course, writing down long lists of what you've done and starting to gradually trim it down. And don't just focus on what the course you're applying for. Think about other interests, wider hobbies, other responsibilities you have, work you've been doing. Start writing a long list, write a long statement and trim it down. It's much easier to reread a statement and cut out the bits you think aren't relevant than it is to try and pad something that's only half a side.
The key elements to a good personal statement are three. First part is introducing yourself, the second part is showing you understand psychology. And the third part is creating something that's a bit unique and a bit interesting that makes you stand out from the crowd. It's just you showing that you have an ambition that relates to psychology, that you have experiences that relate to your university ambition, and basically making yourself not just a statistic, but a person.
You might have done some work experience, for example, in a nursery, or you've done some babysitting, and you'd pursued that interest by reading a book on developmental psychology and gone from there to talk about a particular experiment or a particular area of developmental psychology that interested you.
Your statement has got to leap out. Ask yourself this question. If you put your statement into a pile of statements and gave them to a group of friends, would they be able to pick yours out? So personal statements are just that, they need to be personal.
Psychology is a science. And by that I mean that you will be required to learn about experimental design, to learn about using numbers, to extract something meaningful from your data so that we can advance our understanding of psychology and the understanding of science, where we are in the world of psychology. So how do you do that? Well, I mean, I guess the easiest way to do that is just to say, I'm aware that I'll be learning statistics, I know that I have to understand research methodology, and I realise that that's a big part of the course. But there's a better way of doing that. What I am really interested in seeing is that you as an applicant are looking at the real world now and seeing where psychology is making its mark scientifically. Even if you look at something like let's just even pick the BBC News website as an example, you will see in there that there are links to health, to science, to technology. If you explore the news articles within any of those three different domains, you will find examples of psychology in action.
There are many things on YouTube or programmes on Radio 4 that are relevant to subjects. Go and listen to some materials, try and find something that excites you, and then go away and pursue that. You might read The Economist or The New Scientist to follow up on ideas, but just try and engage with your subject and convey that interest in your own personal way.
Think of a relevant experience, could be work experience, could be just a personal experience that you've had, which psychology relates to, such as a chance you've had to persuade people of something, or a time where you've seen psychology used to positive effect.
If you can show me that you have an understanding of that in your personal statement, well, for me, that is reading pure joy. That means that you can show me that you understand exactly what psychology is, where it's placed in the modern world, and that you are part of the future of psychology. My second point is about personal disclosure. Psychology is a particular degree that quite often people are drawn to psychology because of personal issues that they have faced in their own. But the one thing I need to make absolutely clear is that the journey you will be on when you join us to study your degree in psychology is an educational one and not a clinical one. So it's very unlikely that once you leave your undergraduate degree, you will have any better an insight into the personal issues that either you yourself faced or your family members faced or your close friends faced by the time you leave us. It's very likely that you will understand much more about psychology as a whole, that you'll have an understanding of clinical psychology, of personality and individual differences, of potentially forensic psychology, of biological psychology, of cognitive psychology, and so the list goes on and on and on. But this will not be tailor-made for you. And that's something that you really have to keep in mind. Disclosure is absolutely fine, and in fact it can be very engaging for me as an admissions tutor to read all about your journey and how you got to be interested in psychology, but keep it relevant and make it very, very clear that you understand what the psychology degree will give you, and it will not give you a clinical insight into yourself. It will not give you any treatment per se. My final point then, for psychology relevant information, is please make sure that you understand what a psychology undergraduate degree will lead to. So many applicants for psychology are really interested in things like clinical psychology or forensic psychology, educational psychology, and the list goes on. And that's fantastic. We want to know that there are people who are interested in progressing psychology in the future and becoming psychologists in the future. The psychology degree, however, will not qualify you as a clinical psychologist or any other psychologist for that matter. It's a foundation stone. It will give you 3 years and sometimes 4 years of hard graft, at understanding the basics of psychology as a science, of understanding all of the broad-ranging concepts of the toolkit for psychology. Often, I will see in personal statements that students will tell me, I'm really interested in becoming a clinical psychologist. Fantastic. But they're maybe not quite so clear on the fact that once you finish your 3 years of training, the journey doesn't end there. Very occasionally I will see individuals that write that they desperately want to be a counsellor and that the psychology degree will lead to that, or that they would desperately love to be a psychiatrist and that's what they plan on doing after their undergraduate degree. You don't need an undergraduate degree in psychology to be a counsellor, and you need a degree in medicine to become a psychiatrist. If I see this in a personal statement, then sometimes I think, oh gosh, this student doesn't really know exactly what they're getting themselves into.
Get other people who know you well to read it. If you're in school or college, they'll no doubt go through the personal statement with a fine-tooth comb with you and tell you what to include and not include. But get other people to read it, parents, family, friends, people who know you well, and make sure that what they're looking at represents you. They may well think of things that you've just forgotten to mention. And if they read the statement and say, well, who's this? And it doesn't seem a true reflection of you, then start again, because it's about you. It is a personal statement. There's no right or wrong in how you do it. It's about trying to get down a genuine articulation of what you're about, where you're going, why you're applying.